You're listening to Neocash Radio, where we discuss the future of money today. In the studio with you, it's JJ. Special guest Matt Simon will be joining us to talk about cannabis-related cryptocurrencies. Matt works with the Marijuana Policy Project as the New England political director and legislative analyst, but more recently has gotten involved with cryptocurrencies. Welcome to the show, Matt.
JJ, thanks for having me.
Excellent. So we're talking about crypto related to cannabis, and as we've talked about past episodes of Neocash Radio, there are a few different applications for this, but why don't we get right into it? Matt, in your day job, so to speak, you deal with marijuana and a legislative and statewide, state-by-state manner, right, as far as passing legislation and things like that. And you have just recently gotten involved with crypto. Now, you're very new to this, aren't you?
I would say crypto-curious.
Crypto-curious.
And very recently, you know, trying to learn as much as I can about this. But yeah, back to my day job, I'm trying to legalize marijuana in all 50 states. That's our mission at the Marijuana Policy Project. And marijuana is legal now in 8 states, and legal regulated markets have come on board in Colorado, Washington, and they're happening in Oregon and Alaska as well. And 4 more states just passed it, including California, which is a huge market, and Massachusetts and Maine, which brings it to the Northeast. And this is an interesting area potentially for cryptocurrency, because one of the challenges facing legal marijuana businesses is that their product is still illegal under federal law, and traditional banks, are reluctant to deal with them. Now, many marijuana businesses do have traditional banking, but many don't and have to deal in cash, and that creates risk for everybody who's carrying
a honeypot. Not only do you have drugs, but you have cash too.
Right, and it's expensive to pay security companies to haul your cash around and make payments. So there's a potential for cryptocurrency here. So I gets me wondering, you know, how much is this going to be addressed by things like Bitcoin and Ethereum? And then Dennis Rodman went to North Korea last week.
Yes, this captured Matt's attention. And
I've been watching Dennis Rodman play basketball since his rookie year in the NBA. And he still gets my attention every time he does something. So Potcoin sent Dennis Rodman to North Korea.
Potcoin sent Dennis Rodman to North Korea. And it almost doesn't make sense in a way. I mean, maybe it's a genius marketing move, though.
Well, it might be, and it at least got me to think about the fact that they exist, and that in fact there are probably other cannabis-themed cryptocurrencies, which I've spent the last week, you know, doing a web search and trying to find out how many there are, and there are a bunch. There's ganja coin and hemp coin and sativa coin and dope coin and just
420
whole bunch of them out there.
Yeah. Many of them don't offer much utility. They're mainly just a blockchain currency. There isn't much built into it, and they're usually copies of Litecoin or some other script mining, because you can't use SHA-256 to mine coins anymore, because if you compete with Bitcoin, the ASICs will just destroy
it. So that's what I've gathered. But in my preliminary research, which is, to be clear, very preliminary, and I'm not an expert on any of this stuff. And I should also be clear that my employer has no position on any of this, and I haven't even talked to my
colleagues.
This
is not related to the Marijuana Policy Project based out of Washington, D.C.
Right. But as a marijuana policy expert who is interested in cryptocurrencies, I'm here to share my preliminary deep dive into this.
Excellent.
And two that I found that are interesting are Potcoin, as we mentioned, and another one called Tokes. Which is a great name. Very ambitious business plan that I looked at a little bit. So,
well, you know, and this is a very interesting area, because as we mentioned on the show previously, when the banks shut you down and all you have is cash, this presents a great security risk. But crypto allows you to buy and sell things without actually having a safe full of money that someone can come along and loot. You can have your crypto sent to an out-of-store wallet. You know what I'm saying? It doesn't even have to go to a wallet in the store, and there can be a hot wallet for refunds and change and things like that. But there are so many more security bonuses to using crypto for your transactions. And then, of course, as we've seen, the feds will still raid your legal business in your state, and in fact, they'll do it for raw milk. You know, it's not just a pot thing. You know, if the feds disagree with what the state is doing, regardless of whether it's marijuana or milk, they're going to come in and raid you and things like that, and they're going to take your stuff. Well, obviously, it's a lot harder to take your crypto if it's not there. But Matt, let's go into Potcoin if you want to start there.
Yeah. And, awesome. You know, there are a lot of things to be concerned about.
Yes.
The federal uncertainty yes. from the Department of Justice is certainly one of them. But yes. anybody who's hauling around large amounts of cash and transacting in large amounts of cash is going to want electronic alternatives
yes.
to that. So Potcoin is one that I looked into. It's been around for a few years. It was originally a fork of Litecoin QT, and they moved it over to a POSV system, which I'll let you explain.
Yeah, so the proof of stake velocity is what it's called. It's based off of what Redcoin came up with, and basically it sort of flips the coin days around a bit. Instead of gaining coin days over time, that increases over time. You gain coin days rapidly at the beginning, the first 2 weeks that you're holding it in this same address, and it encourages you to move that currency within 2 weeks, really. So it's all about moving the money and the velocity of money sort of series. But proof of stake means that they don't have miners. There's no one sitting there with GPUs in their garage mining these coins. It's all done on the network through active nodes and the proof of stake mining algorithm. So
the idea is the more you use it, the more...
Well, it's very efficient. That's the thing about proof of stake. Some of the security concerns might be a bit more in a way than proof of work, but the thing is that you're not wasting all this electricity running clock cycles, basically. You're just actively monitoring, processing, and securing the node and the network, so... It's a lot easier to get into, a lot lower barrier entry. Anybody then can stake. You know what I'm saying? You don't have to have a miner to stake. You don't have to have this technology, nor the know-how to set it up and make it run. You just simply hold the coins in your address, in your wallet. So it's a lower barrier to entry. A lot more people can get on board quicker. And so it has that going for it.
Right. So it appears that Potcoin is trying to become a standard of exchange within the cannabis industry, and to some extent replace traditional banking. So the website says Potcoin, quote, provides the underserved legal marijuana industry with a decentralized banking infrastructure and payment solution. Using Potcoin, industry members will realize significant cost savings, scalability, and unparalleled enterprise security. So that is an ambitious...
Yes.
plan that
but,
they that
and,
they
and,
have.
And our question obviously then becomes, well, how can you do this better or differently than, say, Bitcoin? Now, obviously, Bitcoin and the network's really difficult right now. You probably don't want to buy a small amount of marijuana or pot or whatever you want to call it with Bitcoin because your fee is $5. You know, that's, you know what I'm saying? It's so it's
yeah.
So then you go, well, is it Ethereum or Dash? You know, who is it? So Potcoin's coming along. What else does Potcoin offer?
Well, they've become, I think part of the reason they've risen to the level
yes.
of at least potential success here that we're at least talking about them is one thing they did in April, they launched their Pot Wallet, which is an app for Android, and it's I installed it. I haven't used it yet,
right.
but it looks like a very easy interface to use. And Potcoin is also on a bunch of platforms now. It's something that you can obtain. So I have, for example, I'm a very newbie crypto trader, but I have a Coinami wallet
right.
that I put some Ethereum into, and Potcoin is supported by Coinami, so I can just click a couple of buttons and buy Potcoin through my Coinami wallet,
yeah.
which has Shapeshift built right into it,
yeah.
and that is how I have...
That's the free market.
Yeah. I bought $50 worth of Potcoin with the idea being I'm probably going to buy marijuana with it someday, and will that be a tiny amount or a large amount is a great question.
This was a great experiment right there, Matt. Buying this with the whole idea that you're going to use it to buy something in the future, but where is that going to take you, right?
So the idea is, I think their success hinges on convincing cannabis consumers and cannabis businesses to use Potcoin to
Yeah.
And to have it become a medium of exchange. So just by it existing and pot wallet being downloaded, the price went up to I think about a dime or a little bit above. And then the publicity of sending Dennis Rodman to North Korea, it went up to about 18 cents.
So
there.
He was wearing a Potcoin t-shirt, right?
Absolutely.
And he came off the plane and the cameras were all on him.
His whole entourage, yeah. They were all wearing Potcoin.
Oh my.
Potcoin t-shirts.
So the marketing
got a lot of coverage and jumped up to about 18 cents. It's gone back down to around 13 and a half, 14 cents since then. But it's, you know, definitely. People are talking about Potcoin, and they're promoting
yes.
it. They have a plan to promote
so
it. They're going to festivals and
that's another perk then of Potcoin is related to like some of these other coins is well Dash they're promoting it. Ethereum no one really needs to promote it, but this is sensational, and that is we're talking about millions and millions of dollars of TV coverage and advertising, you know, PR just from this stunt. It's amazing, bold move. But now let's talk about the audacious Tokes platform. I mean, we'll get back to Potcoin when we wrap up these summaries. But Tokes, I mean, how is it different than Potcoin?
In every conceivable way, Tokes is a very ambitious business plan. I read that white paper over the last couple of days, and it is. First of all, it is a cryptocurrency.
Yep.
Tokes are their own token that also they hope will become a standard medium of exchange within the cannabis.
And it's on
space.
The Waves platform.
It is on the Waves platform, which is a relatively new blockchain, and maybe you can tell us more.
Well,
more
Waves
about that.
is a proof of stake platform that has smart contracts. It makes tokens. There's a built-in exchange, or there's an exchange associated with it, and it's definitely like Ethereum. You know, in many ways, but it's like Ethereum that's already at proof of stake, and it's very new. So there's a lot of things growing on it, and there's a lot of just little plants budding through the soil. But you know, we'll see what actually gets harvested. So Tokes has this ambitious plan.
So one third of that plan is to have a successful cryptocurrency, Tokes.
Okay.
Another third or another point of that plan is to have an actual cannabis business in the state of Nevada, where marijuana was recently legalized.
So an actual brick and mortar business.
They want to grow marijuana and make products. I think they want to process it and be in that business and use the success of their cannabis business to help promote their cryptocurrency.
Right.
And then the third branch of their plan is advocacy.
Right.
They want to have a nonprofit wing that does advocacy both for cannabis and cryptocurrency. That is the three points of the Tokes platform. Very ambitious
plan. I really like the ambition. I really like the idea that we are cross, you know, meta. The whole idea mm-hmm. that you're in the real world. You have a business element in the real world that is doing real world transactions, and you know it's very measurable what you can get in the real world. We've got great statistics and analytics, and then the whole idea of the crypto layer, just having this currency moving around and people using it, promoting it. But then the advocacy. Now that is really, I think, where Tokes stands out among a lot of cryptos, because there are very, very few cryptos that have anything related to advocacy built into them. And the only ones I can really think of, like Dash, is looking at their legal side, and they have paid for legal stuff to be done and things to be looked at and lawyers to be paid, things like that. Other than that. Individual projects take this on, not a whole blockchain. So this is exciting stuff here.
Right. And to be clear, they do have a timeline for each of these three areas that they want to work on. And the advocacy timeline is more of a next year thing.
Yeah.
They're more focused, as one would expect, on getting their product to be adopted. And they're going to start they're based in Las Vegas. Las Vegas now has several medical marijuana dispensaries.
And Nevada just protected blockchains. Amazing bill and law made in Nevada that protects them from a lot of different laws, and it also protects them from taxes. You can't tax mm-hmm. the blockchain. So amazing stuff in Nevada when it comes to blockchain law. And in fact, they're the second state in the United States to allow what happens on a blockchain to be recorded in a court of law. So good stuff.
Yeah, well, it's really interesting, and that'll be the first step of their plan, is can they get the patrons of Vegas-area dispensaries to use tokes, to buy with tokes, and if they can get their own brick-and-mortar cannabis business up and running and can get everybody they transact with to deal in their token, then that also encourages adoption, and then, of course, they want to expand nationally.
I mean, at that point, tokes almost becomes like a, and maybe Potcoin in the same sense, becomes sort of like a customer loyalty or something like that, where you can give them a discount with this currency versus fiat, or you can do special things with it. It really feels like that sort of situation, because like that's the thing that tokes. It's just amazing that this is the company making the blockchain or making the token, and then they're running the store. And so, like, this is so new.
It's not what I expected opened the white paper.
It's very audacious. Very audacious. So,
love a good business plan.
So, where are they on this? Is this still vapor, or is there any movement on getting certain parts of this in the place? Do you know?
Well, Nevada is just in the process of rolling out its licensing for adult use marijuana. They have medical cannabis, their existing dispensaries. That's where Tokes wants to start with adoption. But
so
Nevada voted to legalize marijuana in November of 2016, and they're still...
It still has that sort of grace period before the law actually takes effect, before licenses are actually issued and blah, 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 right?
Yeah, there's a lot of to be determined.
Yes.
But,
so it's something that it's very likely to happen if they have the funding. And the person behind this, did you learn a little bit about him?
Yeah, the founder's name's Michael Wagner, and he has a background in finance
seems like he's self-funded in a way.
Yeah, I don't know anything about where the funding comes in. And again, I cannot comment in any way on this other than to say I'm I found it remarkable, and it'll be an interesting thing to watch.
Well, and that's the thing, is that you look at some of these projects that are coming out, and they're very, bold in what they want to do, and it's all on the blockchain, and it's all programmed, it's all coders. So it's just like get an army of coders, and you can make this happen. But this plan is actually like, building a brick and mortar place, having the currency, and then hiring someone like yourself, for example, to actually go and do the actual legalization efforts and to actually change laws in the other states, that's very bold. And the fact that it's not all on a blockchain is actually gives me more hope about it happening.
Well,
so,
I mean, there's a need for advocacy, certainly for cannabis reform. I mean, we fight as many battles as we can, but our coalitions in every state need more allies. And I think crypto is an area where there are not a lot of cryptocurrency lobbyists out there. It's remarkable to me that some states have passed these types of laws. In New Hampshire, it was all driven by a small number of activists and a handful of well-informed state legislators.
Well, at this point, especially with crypto, you basically have to find... You have to find someone that's in that skill set. Like this example, but you have to find a lobbyist who learns crypto, because if you have this, like a lot of the crypto people, let's face it, where the techies and coders and people who are really into the actual ones and zero side of things, we have no real experience with lobbying or dealing or even dealing with, calling the governor, for example. So like that sort of.
They're really missing out, I got to tell you.
So, what's next for Potcoin? Do you know?
What's next for Potcoin is, I think, anybody's guess. But
so they don't have like a big, this is our plan. I mean, they made the pot wallet. They've done a huge sensational stunt of getting Dennis Rodman to wear their t-shirt. And in fact, when you look at the cryptocurrency market cap, if you will, Potcoin is in the top 100, which is You know, that is something. Some people only look at the first page of these. It's sitting there at 13, around 13 cents, 13, a little over 13, and you know, $28 million worth of market cap. Now, there are 217 million pot coins in circulation, so they have a lot of circulation. That's good. It's very liquid. So, and then the tokes, that's the thing, is that tokes is on the second page, and they might not get the same attention because, let's face it, some people never clicked in the second page. Right. I mean, we have a lot of traders that are entering the market right now that are so new to this that they are really just, they're just throwing their money at the wind. And this last week, you know, we've seen that wind actually kick back in their face as the Coinbase situation happened. And we'll talk more about that on Neocash Radio on our regular show coming up on Wednesday. And you can hear JJ's opinion on why a lot of that was messed up and in a different way than you think. Anyway, getting back to Potcoin and tokes and cannabis-related cryptocurrencies, this marketplace has been around for a while. It's definitely, there is an uptick. I'm, you know, just looking at the data, usage, volume, things like that, there's an uptick, and it seems like there might be some traction here. So the whole idea, it's such, I think, you know, pot and marijuana, whatever you want to call it, it's one of those strange, like, wild card areas, right? Where if you can get involved with that, there are people who really, really appreciate marijuana and cannabis, and they will really throw their support behind anyone that's making that easier to get or better, or you know, improving that community, if you will. So it is this area where you could have a themed currency that would do well,
right?
Or you'd expect that it would do well.
I think the million-dollar question may be, you know, just how many retail stores and dispensaries are going to accept Potcoin, accept tokes, accept Bitcoin, accept Ethereum, accept Dash.
Right.
And, you know, I mean, most of the money that, I mean, currently we're talking about at least a $50 billion illegal industry where people are spending US dollars and, you know, spending them into the illicit market for marijuana. And what we have is now just a very small number of states that have rolled out $5-6 billion worth of a legal market. That's going to expand dramatically as California and Nevada, Massachusetts, and Maine come online. And that's, you know, many more states poised to do this in the coming years. So it's a unique opportunity in the sense that it's a hugely emerging market that's coming out of the shadows and into the light. But And throw in the factor that so many of these businesses do have to operate in cash and deal with that level of uncertainty, or maybe a business maybe they have an account, but one of their suppliers or somebody they sell to is stuck dealing in cash because they can't get the
bank to take
the risk.
Electric company typically.
Right.
Well, they need a solar roof on that place. it's awesome. I'm looking forward to seeing it. And in fact, Canada looks, you know, if they legalize, you know what I'm saying? That's a huge chunk of the market there.
And they are legalizing.
Right.
And Potcoin was actually founded in Montreal.
Oh, wow. So there you go. Yep. Wow. Well, thank you so much for joining us, Matt. It's
it's
pleasure.
It's been a pleasure.
You were on the show a while ago. You spoke with Randy, Pedro, and Darren, right?
Yes.
And you just talked about the ramifications of the war on drugs in an economic sense and sort of a human sense. And listeners can check out that podcast a while ago. We look forward to having you on again, Matt. This is good stuff here. And of course, congratulations on all your efforts to do your actual day job.
Well, thank you very much.
Because New England is almost fully legal. We're getting there.
It's fully decriminalized.
Fully decriminalized. Yes.
People aren't going to be arrested for simple possession anymore in any of those six states.
Well, that's a pretty good success record right there. As the New England director.
It's a start.
Yeah. Awesome. Great attitude. Well, this is JJ.
And Matt.
For Neocash Radio. And as always, you can visit neocashradio.com to find out more about all of our stuff and our episodes. Oh, yeah, there's the music. You know it, Neocash Radio. Tune in every Wednesday. Now, I understand we missed this last week, but tune in every Wednesday for a new episode of Neocash Radio, where we discuss the future of money today. Neocashradio.com.